That's right, this is not a drill. FreeCAD 0.20 is finally out. And of course, the number one question that so many of us are thinking is it still fundamentally broken? And if you have no idea what I'm talking about here, go and check out the video that I mentioned where I think FreeCAD is fundamentally broken. It's in the cards or linked down in the description. So let's dive straight into it and give it a go. I have this already set up. I'm gonna pull out that middle block. And there you have it. It is still broken. But wait, there is so much more news to come. First and foremost, a huge thank you to developers and the community. Truly, it's beautiful to see all this development going on and really go and read the release notes. There is so much in this update. It is incredible. And remember that all this needs your support to carry on growing. Now, with that said, I need to let you know that there is another update coming. And this is not going to be FreeCAD 0.21. No, this is FreeCAD 1.0. And this update already has set as a development goal to deal with the topology naming problem. It is incredible to see that in writing, and I cannot wait for it to come out. Now, yes, that does mean that we're going to have to wait a little bit longer. There is no real date set right this minute, not that I can see, only maybe a placeholder. It says 2023, but any other information that I find out, I'll link in the top pinned comment of this video. Now, I do have some more news for you here, which is as soon as FreeCAD 1.0 comes out and I get up to speed with it, I'm going to do an entire free course here on Maker Tales of FreeCAD from the baby steps beginning all the way to some pretty advanced use cases. And I cannot wait to be able to do that. So I just wanted to let you know, FreeCAD 2.0 is out. Some incredible updates. Go and check them out. The topology naming problem is still in there, so you're going to have to do some pretty advanced workflows to deal with it. Of course, advanced users, you're not going to have a problem with that. If you're just sort of doing a couple of little bits of 3D printing, it's going to still be a pain to deal with, but all of that might soon be part of the past. Oh, and a completely different note, I just want to mention that for you that are looking at the sort of CAD-like modeling, take a look at CAD Sketcher. It brings CAD-like functionality into Blender. It's completely for free. It's a new open source project. It's incredible. It is still very much in early development, but I really encourage you to go and check it out, especially if you're just looking to do a couple of 3D printing things, because there is some incredible possibilities when you bring CAD-like functionalities into Blender. Now, it is very, very, very early days, but it's looking like it's going to turn into something very interesting indeed. Now, it's no FreeCAD whatsoever. FreeCAD is FreeCAD, and it's on a whole nother level, but this CAD Sketcher is pretty interesting. So go and give that a little look. A huge thank you to my patrons. You guys are absolutely awesome. And a massive thank you to my VIP makers, Jem Oskanak and David Fernandez. Without you guys, I truly couldn't make Maker Tales. And if you're enjoying what I'm making here and you think I'm worthy of your support or excited for what I'm about to be making in the future, I would love to see you there too. Thank you for watching. Keep making and let the quest continue.